Hare Krishna. So now we are going to discuss the pastimes of Lord Vitthal with his devotees. And today we are going to discuss one very special devotee of Lord Vitthal, and she is Kanupatra. So Kanupatra was the daughter of one of the prostitute named Adushyama, and she was living in the town of Mangalveda, which is just nearby the Pandharpur. And so when she was born, she was very, very beautiful. From her childhood only, she was taught how to dance, how to sing, and soon she became very much talented. But you know, because she was the mother, the Shama was a prostitute, although they were living in a palatial building, and you know, but still, you know, they were considered as a degraded because of the mother's profession. And they were basically not knowing who is the father of this Kanupatra is. But when the mother was suspecting, there was the town head whose name was Sadashiv Malgujar. He is the father, who is the suspected father of the Kanupatra. She was believing that. So the Sadashiv Malgujar, one day when he saw that, you know, he heard the glories of the Kanupatra's dancing and singing, he was attracted towards her and he wanted to enjoy with her. But then Shama told him, you know, she is your daughter, how can you, you know, even think of enjoying with her? So he told, you know, he denied, no, you are a prostitute, you know, so many, you are getting united with so many people, you know, she is not my daughter, she may be of someone else, I want to enjoy with her. And he was insisting the Kanupatra to come with him, and you know, he was you know, harassing both the mother and daughter. But you know, the daughter Kanupatra didn't have any attraction towards this material world. So she would always tell her mother that, mother, I don't want to get married with any mortal person, any person who is going to die. I want to get married with a person who is more beautiful than me. So then, you know, she don't wanted to continue the profession of the prostitution. So the Shama had also the maid servant whose name was Hausa, and the Hausa was the staunch devotee of Lord Vitthal. She was the Varkari, and she would always tell the glories of Lord Vitthal to the Kanupatra. And from childhood only, she was attracted towards the Vitthal. So one night they thought, you know, this harassment is enough. Now I should live with this Hausa, you know, to Pandharpur. So at least for that time, you know, harassment will be stopped. So, you know, thinking that way, she left the palatial kingdom and she went with the Hausa to the Pandharpur. So while walking in the Pandharpur, she was asking the Varkaris, you know, how Vitthalji looks. Does he look beautiful than me? Will he accept me? So that time they told, you know, the beauty of the Vitthal is a million times more than the Lakshmi Devi also. You know, what to say of you? And do not worry, you know, Lord Vitthal has accepted the Gajendra, Lord Vitthal has accepted the Kubja, who was the maid servant of the king Kamsa. Lord Vitthal has accepted the Ajamil, so he will accept you also, don't worry, you just come with us. So she was very happy, and when they arrived in the Pandharpur, you know, she was very happy to take the darshan of Lord Vitthal's lotus feet, and she was very much attracted towards Lord Vitthal's lotus feet. She was just praying, crying. And soon she became, you know, the devotee of Lord Vitthal. She always would come and, you know, sing a song, and she would dance for the pleasure of Lord Vitthal. She soon get married with the Lord Vitthal. And, you know, she was just living nearby the temple. Here, the Sadashiv Malgujar was searching for the, you know, Hausa and the Kanupatra. He was thinking where they have gone. And he came to know she is staying in the temple of the Vitthal. So he informed the king of Bidar that, you know, there is some particular very beautiful girl, very talented girl, you know, she should be enjoyed by you only. So you capture her and you marry with her. So by hearing her glories, the king of Bidar also thought, okay, oh, she is so beautiful girl, I must get married with her. So he sent his soldiers to capture the Kanupatra, and Kanupatra denied it. Then, you know, the soldier told, if you don't come with us, you know, we will take you forcefully, and you know, we will also destroy the temple of the Lord Vitthal, so better you come with us. So that time Kanupatra told the soldier, you know, you better do one thing, you know, I will come, you just wait outside for me, I'll have my last meeting with Lord Vitthal. That time Kanupatra came in front of a Vitthal, and you know, she was crying. She is telling the Lord Vitthal that she was praying intensely to the Lord Vitthal, and she was telling, you know, I am only property of you. I don't want to get touched by anyone of this world. You know, you take out my soul and, you know, merge into yourself. I don't want to go with them. I don't want to get enjoyed by somebody else other than you. You are my only husband. Like that she was praying, and that time she sang one wonderful bhajan. She says that, you know, Nako Devaraya Anta Atapahu Pranaha Sarvatha Jau Pahe. So she is praying, you know, oh Lord Vitthal, please do not wait for my, you know, departure. Please protect me, you know, from this, you know, jackals. She is telling Lord Vitthal, you are like the lion. If these jackals, you know, take me away from you, then this will be the defeat of the lion. You know, so you behave like a lion. You know, you please do something. So when she was praying intensely to the Lord, that time, you know, she died at the lotus feet of Lord. Some people say that, you know, she merged into the deity of Lord. Some people say, you know, immediately the river Chandrabhaga, the river overflooded and it killed all the soldiers. Some people say she, you know, just died in front of the Lord Vitthal, and her soul merged into the feet of Lord Vitthal. And, you know, then the Lord Vitthal ordered to the priest that, you know, her dead body should be cremated buried inside the temple only, the southern side of the temple. And when the body was buried, immediately they could see the one very special tree, the Tarati tree, you know, that grown up immediately, and you know, all the soldiers, they were shocked to see that, and they informed the king, and the king came to know the glories of the Kanupatra. He came to know that Kanupatra was not, you know, ordinary girl. She was the pure devotee of Lord. Still, we find her, the samadhi, inside the temple premises. It's the only samadhi which is inside the temple premises. And it's a ritual that whenever you are passing from the queue towards the you know, darshan of the Lord Vitthal, you must take the blessing of the Kanupatra. Kanupatra has written the many, you know, bhajans and ovis to glorify the Lord Vitthal. So these are the glories of, you know, Kanupatra. Lord Vitthal himself protected her. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.